Alrighty, it is that time, once again, where we play new video games. And for the first time on stream, we're going to be playing some, if I turn on the Elgato, some Who Wants to Be a Millionaire, complimentary of Maggie. Hi, Maggie.
Hello.
Maggie has decided to bring a couple of her games over to my place tonight. And one of the two that we have planned are Who Wants to Be a Millionaire. And neither of us have played this version on Switch. So now we need to figure out what the hell we're doing.
I've only watched the show.
And that's my experience too. So yeah, series of 15 questions, increasing difficulty to win $1 million. Challenge your friends on a series of 15 questions. Family mode, which are easier questions. And then online multiplayer. So I think for us, do you want to do solo where you just work together or local multiplayer 1v1?
Let's just do solo.
We'll do solo. We can probably do like two games. We'll do this one and then we'll do the 1v1 maybe. You want to do it on normal or easy?
Oh, no.
Normal or easy? questions with a level of difficulty and themes accessible for the youngest players. There is no timer. And that one's just classic themes.
What do you think?
I think, like, with two brains, we could probably do normal.
Okay.
Okay, and then we have arts, literature, entertainment, geography, history, sports, hobbies, science, lifestyle, and language. Keep it all on?
Sure, why not?
Sure, why not? All right. Oh, who's our player? We got Julie, Misamo, Lindsay, Ruben,
you don't get to pick
Margaret.
Your character. You don't get to make your character.
I know, that's a little dumb, isn't it?
Margaret.
Pablo, Shun, Hang, Nadia, Jorge?
Georges?
Julie. Oh, we're back to the beginning. Julie, Misamo, yeah. I don't know, anyone look appealing to you?
Either Julie or Margaret. 22.
She's
a student.
Still a student. She's very social. A little dumb that we can't make our own person, though. I do agree.
Press any button. Too good.
That was an abrupt cut in.
Was jamming to the music.
Welcome to Who Wants to Be a Millionaire?
Why is the subtext
ready
all the way up there?
Okay, let's go.
Why is it not on the bottom? That looks weird.
You're not Meredith Vieira.
Tonight we're gonna give it our all to answer the questions, but most importantly, we're gonna have a good time.
Good luck. Here we go.
That why? Because our character talks?
Well, you know the money ladder. 15 questions, and at the top, the million. To help you, we have four lifelines at your disposal.
Four lifelines.
Phone a friend, the 50-50, ask the audience, and switch the question.
Switch the question is one I'm not familiar with. It sounds very self-explanatory.
It's time to move on to a new question.
I've never... What?
Saturday Night Live.
Let's go with the right answer, and therefore...
I will take it from you. Do I have to press A again? I do.
Final?
Oh, yes. That's my final answer.
Okay. I would rather make my own character and have them not talk, honestly. Yeah, I knew not. Like, out of all the options, that was probably going
to
be the one I would have guessed. But I did not know it.
Here's a new question for you.
He's a writing utensil with a nib? Oh no.
I'm either thinking A, but I'm
thinking either A or B, but
I was thinking A or C, but
we know it's not D. What does pyramid mean? Oh, it's just that. Go with A, fuck it.
Sure.
A, fuck it.
Going to be the right answer. I can feel it.
I can feel it.
So this is your final answer?
Yes, that's my final answer.
Yes, that's
you have given your final answer. I hope it is the right one.
Me too.
Well done.
Okay, cool.
Cool.
We believe it. It's climbing quickly. Let's keep our streak going.
Her voice is
annoying.
Her.
Yeah.
Should have went with Margaret.
We'll go with Margaret next game. If you deal with the challenge well, you are said to pass with flying colors. That's easy. Kalooers.
They spelt it wrong.
Kalooers.
Okay. Just pass with flying foxes. I like that.
Are you sure?
Pass with flying jackets.
Pass with flying picket.
I thought it said pickles at first.
Pickles? Oh, it's a pickles?
That's what we were looking for.
That was so easy. That's
I
the
still
first
have
question.
My totally off topic. Cool and it paid off. Listen, I have my Slim Jim at home. I never ate that. That's off topic, though. In
theory. A ship in good enough condition to sail is said to be what is it? No. Is it sea fit? Seaworthy. There it is.
Seaworthy. Disc.
Let's try D.
You know what my next question is, right? Is this your final answer?
Yup.
That will be my final answer.
You have given your final
answer. Got a hair sticking up in the back.
I see that.
You figured it
We're gonna get our million easy.
Nice answer.
Okay, next one.
It's time to move on to a new question.
Oh crap.
The capital of the US state of Nevada. At Carson City. Fuck Manning.
Let's take a deep
I
breath.
Suck
I wanna say it's Manning. What?
I suck at these
like geography?
So, geography is not my thing.
Do we wanna use the thing? Since neither of us are super confident? Or do you wanna say fuck it?
Starbucks?
9 seconds.
I don't know, you go. What do you think?
Fuck it!
I'm gonna say Carson City.
I know you are waiting for
if it's not this one, I think it's Starbucks.
So let's go. Is this your final answer?
Carson, but I don't know.
Oh, yes. That's my final answer.
Oh, I can't wait to see the correct answer. Oh, I'm so sorry.
Out of a bitch.
It's over? Seriously?
I had a feeling it sounded right.
Oh, when no, I hear Carson, so I think of a name. I think of Call Me Carson, the YouTuber. Woo!
Hey, we got zero.
Woo!
The stink of geography.
Hmm?
I hate geography.
Oh, I do too. Alright, we're going back in it. Let's do another solo. That was very quick. Normal. Keep it going. Oh, can we change our person? Will it let us change our person? It will. Alright, yeah, I don't know. Let's get a... Yeah, where's she at? Pablo and Margareth, 69, retired, passion of mini golf.
You like mini golf?
So do you.
No.
Hmm?
I don't.
Okay. Sorry, that was funny.
I'm sorry, but it came out weird.
Which of these phrases describes a miserly person? Penny pinching, sterling sealing, lira looting, and nickel nicking? Miserly?
I know it's not penny pinching.
Nickel nicking either.
A miserly person?
Top five.
A sterling stealing? I don't know.
B. Yes, B.
And now to the
I'm Shane B. Yes, B.
Is this your final answer?
Oh.
Yes, that's my final answer.
Oh, yes, okay. That's my final answer.
Your answer.
And Penny pinching up miserably?
It's the end for you.
Miserably.
What does that mean?
Hey Siri, what's the definition of miserly?
Miserably means
not miserably. Okay. We're gonna Google this. Miserly. Of or characteristic of a miser. Miserly.
Okay.
I'm Mr. Heat Miser.
I'm Mr. Sun.
So being a miserly person, I guess, is just somebody that takes. Not a good person. Penny pincher, I guess, is not a bad person.
A penny pincher means that you like
stingy with money.
Yeah.
Yeah. You are correct, and so am I.
But that's not always it's not always a bad thing. It's like someone who's very like
conservative with their money.
Yeah. It can be, but
right, if someone you have just been talking to suddenly appears to you, say, talk of the blank. Talk of the
It's speak of the devil, isn't it?
I'm pretty sure it's B, though.
Yeah. I think it's that.
And too bad if I'm wrong.
And too bad if I'm wrong.
What will be your final answer?
Yes, that's my final answer.
Yes, that's my final answer.
She kind of makes me think of Grandma from Hoodwinked. You know what I'm talking about?
I don't think I watched that.
Oh, it's a good movie.
Maybe I did. I don't remember.
You should find it and watch it. You don't really need to scare me
like that, okay? Okay.
If you scare me, I might get a heart attack. Which of these people was a veteran U.S. news anchor? Steve Allen, Jay Leno, Arsenio Hall, and Walter Cronkite.
Who's Arsenio Hall? Sounds familiar, but I don't know who it is. I know it's not Jay Leno. He's a talk show host.
Well, a U.S. news anchor. Hey, Steve Allen.
Try it.
Sure. We know what happened last time.
Walter Cronkite.
You call it. 5 seconds.
Who's Arsenio Hall? I don't know. Walt. Just Steve. He
seems quite appropriate. You gotta do that way quicker than the last second.
Sure?
That will be my final answer.
Arsenio Hall, who is that?
Probably gonna be the correct answer, knowing our luck.
Nope, it's Walter. I'm gonna say Walter Cronkite. Dang it.
We get nothing!
Who's Arsenio Hall?
This is going great. Also, I just want to point out, nice.
I knew you were going to do that.
Yeah. You hang. He's a designer with a passion of music. Let's see what he can do.
I think we all agree that we can move on to this new question.
What color are the 50 stars on the U.S. flag? That's an easy one.
Orange.
Purple.
What?
What's the last black?
It's blind.
Beef, no doubt.
And now to the
most important Australian question.
It does kind of sound Australian, but he looks Asian. Answer.
That will be my final answer.
Oh, it's all not. It's right.
No, it's British. It's British.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Purple E.
And one more point for yours truly.
No, that's Australian. That's Australian. What part of your body are affected by fallen arches?
Your feet.
Your ribs.
It's definitely A.
It's definitely Final. A.
That's my Australian. Final answer.
That's my the final answer. Yeah!
I'm amazing. That is not what he said. He said, yeah.
Yeah.
Yes. The seat of the U.S. government is in which city?
Oh my god. Washington, D.C.
Yeah, what the f- The New York. Oh,
come on. I know the answer, of course. I'm going to say, hey.
Are you sure?
That will be my final answer.
That will be my final answer.
The computer validated your answer.
Why did you just voice Mr. Well, Vinkoff? Right.
Oh no.
Obviously that was the right answer.
This is from a movie we watched recently. It's an animated movie.
Offers you a new question.
Which sport would you play the back nine? Golf! That's a golf! Give me a golf.
I'm going to choose B.
I'm going to choose B.
Is this your final answer?
That's my final answer.
You know what he makes me think of? It's actually not a movie. The correct answer. Jolk. I'm really feeling it.
Absolutely.
It's Shulk Xenoblade.
I'm amazing.
Here's a new question for you.
What U.S. state is closest to the island of Cuba?
Geography questions.
Isn't that Florida?
Which state is closest to the island
Florida.
Of Cuba? I guess so. Oh no. It's Do Florida. Not ask me okay. geography or chemistry questions. Yeah, you're not gonna get it out of me.
All three of those are to the left. Cuba is to the right.
Yes, to the left, to the left. Final answer.
Oh, I can't wait to see the correct answer. You just got to that important threshold.
We were one away on the first try.
Wait, what?
We were one away from getting to our first threshold.
Oh. What's threshold mean?
Every five questions. It's question? Like if you fuck up now that you get that minimum. But 1,000 is the least we can get right now.
Ooh, we no matter what, we go home.
We get 1,000. Is the Major League Baseball team based in Atlanta?
Atlanta Braves!
Braves?
Yeah.
Boom. You're here for the sports.
You know what my next question is, right? Is this your final answer?
That will be my final answer.
My final answer.
You have given your final answer. I hope it is the right one. Well done.
It's actually the Atlanta Thrashers.
Obviously, that was the right answer.
Obi.
Now is Shulk time. That is Shulk. That is Shulk.
You're going to make short work of this new question.
Who is the symbol for which chemical element?
Oh.
Chlorine? No.
I just said don't ask me.
How?
It's not. Isn't it copper?
You sure?
I know it's not calcium, but I don't think it's carbon. It's either copper or chlorine.
Do we want to bank it on one of them or should we use the lifeline?
It's up to you.
How confident are you in your answer?
I told you I hate chemistry, so I'm not confident at all.
50-50.
Okay, let's take away two incorrect
answers.
Well,
that doesn't help because I'm pretty sure 50-50 it's copper or chlorine. I told you that.
Which one?
I'm saying copper.
I'm going to choose B.
That was funny. Sorry.
I told you that.
That's my final answer.
Now it's time to find out the correct answer.
That's okay, cool.
A little bit of chemistry helped.
For yours truly.
If you use 50-50, it's gonna only do copper and chlorine. Like, nah, no, it won't.
Concentrate. Here's a new question for you.
The American Dennis Tito became the first.
First to pay to go where? Dennis Tito?
Well, wouldn't be into space. I don't think it's Mount Everest.
It's one of the poles.
Say south. I don't know.
Who's the American Dennis Tito?
The North Pole? I don't know. Something South Pole is sticking out to me, but like, It could be your fault.
Throwing in the hat.
Hey.
And now to the
you're giving me the 50-50. I just have to choose from the 50-50.
Is this your final answer?
Yep, that's my final answer.
The choice is made.
Bomb Chulk, we're making it to the million.
The right answer.
Into space.
Into space.
I feel like
this is not the right answer.
Sorry. Seems cliche, no?
No way!
First person to pay to go. That makes sense.
You
are
leaving with you missed that part.
Well, yes, but
a good game. Good try.
We'll get a plane for the other things too. I still have no idea who the American Dennis Tito is. You get 40 points for $1,000. Dude, we're never gonna be able to unlock the other questions. Let's try head to head. Let's see how we go with that. Okay. Well, everyone must agree and validate the same answer. Everyone wins or loses. Okay. Each player has their own controller and chooses. Why does it keep saying his? Chooses their answer secretly. When all players have answered, the correct answer is revealed. All players play until the million-dollar question, and the points are counted at the end of the game. Okay, I like that. Taking turns. Each player answers a different question when it is their turn. The player who answers incorrectly are eliminated. Okay. So do you want to just go to the million and just get points that way?
Sure. So we need two different controllers.
Yes, we cannot share a controller.
A hand.
Oh, you can also do sideways Joy-Con. Oh.
Thanks.
Oh. I am player one. Alright, we'll keep everything going. Alright. I'll stay hang. So who will you be? A manager with the passion for astronomy.
For Sunday, but
Two tails. Oh yeah, that's true.
And we're on. Let's play Who Wants to Be a Millionaire together.
Play.
Are you ready for this new question?
Who goes first? Oh, we just press a button.
What button? Oh, I press. Wait. What button do we press?
The button that we think it is.
How do you know which one is which?
The one that's lit up.
Wait, what? I'm confused.
So you see the yellow next to the answers?
Mm-hmm. Oh, I can't see the ones over there.
Because you're laying down.
No, because that car's blocking them.
Do you want me to move the cars or?
You have made your choice. Let's find out the right answer together.
It's an Osbert.
This new question shouldn't give you a hard time, in theory.
Collection of playing cards.
Choice is made.
Sorry, that was just funny. Right answer.
The right definitely answer. The funnel. The
funnel cake. I love the funnel cake deck.
New question coming up. Good luck to you.
Oh.
All right, let's find out the right answer together.
Question is, who's going to be the first one to fuck up?
Without further ado, here's the right answer. Our team of editors offers you a new question.
Oh God! No.
If this is your final answer,
dude, all three of the other words, I had no idea what the fuck they were, and then the fourth one popped up. I'm just like, yeah, that makes sense.
And now, yep. Let's find out the right answer.
Dimnabe.
I think we all agree that we can move on to this new question.
Ooh, oh, do you know this?
No.
Uh-oh.
Shut up.
Uh-oh.
A trick question. I'm not good at this.
Plot twist, I actually don't know either.
Oh, you don't either?
No.
All right, let's find out.
Great minds think alike.
What?
It's a great minds think alike.
Let's find out the right answer together.
I thought it was Germany, because Germany is the home of a lot of board games, but it is American currency.
I was thinking US currency, that's why I was like...
Well, because there are other versions with different currency.
Yeah.
Because, again, Germany is known for board games, which is why I was thinking Germany, but that was not an answer. Oh, no. Oh no, there's a couple of answers here. This is going to be where we get different answers. Not happy with my answer. This is where we finally see who takes the lead.
The right one. And the right answer is the following.
Son of a bitch!
I just took a shot in the dark. Oh
no, that's fair. That's fair. I mean, my other answer would have been wrong too, so.
What was it?
It would have been C.
I was gonna put Liberty Bell.
Before Abraham.
Oh, crap.
You don't know this one?
No, I have... Yeah, I'm having a brain fart.
Oh, uh-oh.
You have made your choice.
Yeah, you're right.
I was like, wait, is it 16 or 18?
That's what I figured you were getting stuck on.
Oh.
There's no way he was 14, no way he was 11. Man, if it weren't for that one question. That's gonna be my one question I get wrong this entire thing, too.
The game is off to a good start, but you shouldn't stop there. Here is a new question.
Mr. Rochester's house? Who the fuck? What? I don't know any of this. What?
I have no idea.
I don't know who Mr. Rochester is. Let alone who Charlotte Bronte is. Jane Eyre. Oh, you didn't even answer.
Oh, I pressed it.
Were you mashing up? I mash up.
The right answer was therefore the following.
Dang it.
Is that what you're gonna be, what you're gonna choose?
No.
No? Okay. It doesn't really matter, but yeah, no, definitely mash it.
Okay.
Yeah, you're on a good lead, though.
Here's a new question for you.
It's originally formed in the U.S. That one I actually do know.
I suck at it.
This one's an easy one, though.
Let's hope it's the correct answer.
All I could think of was a push.
I believe this one's actually something you learn in, what's the senior year one?
Government? I learned an A push.
Actually, no, you do learn an A push as well. They just capitalize more in it in government.
Oh, AP US history. We go, there's a whole
well, yeah, but they go over it is again there too, because they talk about the court system and whatnot. The Mafia.
Or did you just get?
Yes.
The choice is made.
Do you know?
No.
This is the moment you've all been waiting for.
These are the two that sound like the most weird ones. Motherfucker!
I just took a guess.
Yeah, one funny number. Yeah, you're winning, GG.
Hey, there's
some... a new question that I hope won't worry you.
The Berlin Wall fall? Oh, they're given specific days. Oh no!
I have two dates.
I'm also looking at two different dates. Which is why I'm choosing the wrong of the two.
If this is your final answer,
can you pick
let's
our
hope it's the correct answer.
Honest to God, I wasn't even thinking about it for that reason. I was just thinking, November.
That was my second choice. Right
April together. Was my second guess.
Oh, you got it right.
Okay,
so
cool.
Apparently the Berlin Wall fell on our anniversary.
Cool, we're known for the Berlin Wall falling down.
Now that you've released the pressure, here's a new question.
Einstein received the Nobel Prize in Physics. Oh no, I don't know this.
Oh, really?
One of these sound more correct than the other answer.
I have no idea.
You have given your final answer. Yeah. I hope it is the right one. Without further delay.
Looks like I was thinking, like, my grandpa, I think, was born in 1923, and I'm like,
oh,
okay, maybe.
Awkward.
I was just like, wait, so he's around him, like, okay.
Yeah, no, that caught me off guard, too. I thought he was, like, a whole 100 years sooner.
Here's a new question for you.
Oh, what the heck? Why would I know that?
Hmm?
Why would I know that?
Why do we care?
Of course. Oh, let's think.
Come on, Shulk, you should know. You can see the future, not the past. Your guess. I got nothing.
Your final answer.
That was my other guess.
Let's hope it's the correct answer.
Tennessee was my other guess. I don't know why Tennessee, but.
Without further ado, here's the right answer.
Well, yeah.
It would have been correct, too.
This is going great for us.
The game is off to a good start, but you shouldn't stop there. Here is a new question.
What'd you do?
Oh, I can't wait to see the correct answer. Without further delay, let's find out the right answer.
Yeah. It comes down to this final question, because if you fuck it up and I get it, I think I take it.
What year did Mario Brothers come out?
This new question.
That's what I'm waiting for.
You to be answered with flying.
Oh no.
Oh crap. The title of the.
Oh, it's all come down to luck.
Think of the mind of which Chinese philosopher?
A dog.
Dang it, the title.
Oh, wait, I fucked up, didn't I? Oh, shit, I think I fucked up.
Why, you know this?
I think I do. I'm not gonna say anything until you enter. I also just realized he gave us 5 minutes to answer this one. I don't know if it's been adding up all of our leftover time.
No, or... it's... Maybe, but I think it's harder questions get longer time.
I guess.
Okay,
I think it's, yeah. I think it's Confucius.
What was my second answer?
The right answer is the following.
Where I was stuck between C. Oh,
okay.
Right.
I knew it was a Tzu one, but then I was like, no, Confucius. That sounds way too familiar. Thankfully, it wasn't Straw Dox. So the thing is, we got the same amount of answers wrong, but you got more in a row.
Yeah.
So good game. And there was only 3 questions that the both of us got wrong.
Yeah.
We make an okay tag team. Alright, so we're currently at 40 minutes. Do you want to try another round of this, or do you want to move on to the other game? I am interested about one thing. I think we get to work together for it. Online multiplayer. Pretty sure we put up with like 7 other people. Oh god, up to 99 people. Do you want to go US or international?
The US.
Take on 99 other millionaires. And then after this, we can swap. But I just remember reading this on the box, and it really got me, like, curious. We are 1 of 100. How much you want to bet there's not a single other person playing who wants to be a millionaire right now?
Probably. If there's no other people, we'd just not start?
I think we'd be the only one. Because I think it works like Battle Royale, like Last One Standing. And if we're the only one, I think the game would just end and we would win.
Yay! Has it ever happened? Fortnite, there's only been one person.
I think the lowest I've ever seen is like 40 to start a game.
What's the lowest that they'll do?
Well, one.
But like, will they let 2 people play?
Well, okay, because Fortnite, if you are a large enough creator on any platform, which is having 1,000 followers on whatever it is, then you can let Epic know and they can give you a creator code. And by having a creator code, you can set up custom lobbies. And with the custom lobby, you can have as little as 2 people. but the rest would be filled with bots. Before bots were a thing, the lowest you could have in a lobby is 2. But now it's filled up with bots. I don't think they'd think of bots for Who Wants to Be a Millionaire because it's a questionnaire. That's a little disappointing, but there is not a single person in the world playing Who Wants to Be a Millionaire right now. But I mean, who doesn't want to be a millionaire at 1:20 in the morning? What if we go international? I am really curious about this, but now I know we're going to get some Japanese people and they're going to know every single question. Or they're going to cheat. Last chance? Alright, somebody in the entire world. One person. Honestly, I don't think so either. It's a pretty exciting.
Super duper.
Again, the idea of Who Wants to Be a Millionaire Battle Royale just sounds really cool, but not a single person in the world thinks so.
Fight to win $1 million.
I'd fight someone for $1 million. I don't care who the person is, as long as I'm guaranteed not dying, I'll fight them for $1 million.
What'd you say?
I said I don't care who I'm fighting. As long as I'm not going to, like, a hospital, as long as I'm not going to my grave after fighting the person, I'll take the million. Think about it, that million could pay for your hospital bills.
Yeah.
Pay now, money later. Alright, not a single person is playing Who Wants to Be a Millionaire in the world right now.
Oh.
So I think that's what we're gonna call it. That was cool, I do like the idea of like a 1v1 millionaire. So, yeah, no, I'd say that was definitely a worthwhile bargain grab at Walmart. But, alright, we're going to be right back with Party Arcade, I believe?
Party Arcade.
Yep, we're going to be right back in a couple minutes with Party Arcade. See you guys then.